Okay, what's up? Turn this down. Alright, so I figured I might as well do this while, like, it's still relevant for the fact that, like, I'm never gonna be doing this again, pretty much, so figured I'd just, like, go through this really horribly sloppy run because this was like 2 weeks ago, 2.5 weeks ago. Obviously, since that time, I actually learned how to play a new game. It's just that I didn't want to anymore. Didn't want to do any more runs. So, like, my newest strats and skills and stuff didn't get to be shown. And I wasn't sloppy, you know. So, on this one, we're going to see a sloppy run. It's going to be cool. Yeah, I saw that. I saw that, Ricky. So, Yep. So, let me see. Might make this chat a little smaller. Something like that. I think that'll work. Whatever. Hey, what's up? No, I can't let you freeze, sorry. I'm so sorry. Alright, let me figure out how. You guys just let me know if, like, the audio needs to go up or down or whatever. What's up? Okay, so let us begin.
Resident Evil 4.
Okay. So I don't think you guys will be able to see the splits. Obviously, I don't have them up. So anyways, I'm just gonna talk. Wow. You're so cool, Ricky. Yeah, I always pick normal costume. I hate special one. And anyone that uses it, that's you, Pharaoh. Sorry. Like, it's, like, not any slower to pick it. And it just looks better, so that's all there is to it. So anyways, the run's pretty normal. At the start, obviously, like, normal costume is Master Race. So hit me too? Okay. All this is gonna be normal. I just use the fat strat. There's, like, nothing really in this part that's different, I don't think. You guys gotta remember this is my fourth ever attempt, and it was still a no reset run at this point. I did 3 no reset runs, and then I decided, like, look at this. I was trying to move that, which I don't actually do anymore. I just move over and go straight to the grenade now. So I don't even, like, move that anymore. That's, like, not a thing I do. I just wait and I move everything at the merchant in 1-3. Okay, so I reload here. And nowadays what I do is I point out the window and I point at the cal percent. It's my way of doing cal percent on new game. So, yeah, I do cal percent on new game now, but I didn't in this video because it was a while back. This feels good. I always point to the right. What I was going to do on my world record run whenever I got it, which I'm not doing anymore, was every single run I did when I was recording, I would always look to the right. And I was gonna put in some text that says, like, shout out to Outrage. But that never happened, so I figured I might as well just tell you now. So there would have been a shout out to Outrage, like, Easter egg in my run. So yeah. um So my sum of best is a 137.20-something. And the record's like a 139.20-something. So literally, like, 2 minutes at least can be shaved off of JTB's run if someone wants to just, like, go do it. Like, JTB's run is apparently not that good. I mean, if I can get this close in four runs and not even being a new game runner, then, like, JTB can definitely improve his time. He needs to improve his time. Definitely needs to. And I hope he does. I hope he goes back and I hope he just, like, demolishes it. Like, I want to at least see someone get a 138. 137 is going to be hard, but 138, he needs to get a 138. Your shout out. I can't remember if I do the Ricky plank or not in this, so I can't remember. Alright, so at this point, this is just like a standard 1-2. There's nothing special here. That guy, that grabber guy. No, I'm playing it right now. I use my mind. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, it's recording. because this is the only time you're going to get me to talk about it, so I figured I'd do it. You know what to do? Alright. Alright, you got it. You got it, right? Trying to think of what's coming up next for like difference. Got the point with the special trick of letting go of all the buttons, which I told Pharaoh, which Pharaoh, has that been working for you? Have you been trying it? Or did you just try it that one time and say, screw it, I'll just do it my way? At this point I would like sometimes I would shoot that barrel if I didn't have my first aid spray still. My option is shoot that so that I have a heal for the cabin. I'm trying to go over strats so that people will know, like, my backup strats as well, because you'll never get to see those, like, because I won't be doing attempts. So, that barrel is my backup herb for cabin. That's good, Pharaoh, that's good. I'm glad it's working for you. So, as I was doing this run, my split time, like, it's comparing against game time because I'm using the auto splitter. And my time was of 144.49. That was my time to beat. Isn't that ridiculous? And then I get a 140.28. Like, just dumb. Alright, so at this point, I know the trick on how to do that every time to make that guy run to the left. I know how to do it every time. So I'm gonna make a video showing how to do that. It's real simple. There's just a certain point, and once you hit that certain point as you're running down the pathway, just start running left and it works every time. Like, I'm gonna make a video tutorial on that. Okay, I can't remember if this merchant's a good merchant or not. It's like not even hard, Pharaoh. I mean, like, with all the runs you've done, you should have been able to figure it out. All you gotta do is just, like, when you see him, basically, once you turn the corner, you stay on the farthest right. Once you see him, you just, like, start running left, and he just follows you. And then you just run around him. Alright. Couldn't sell it. Could not sell it. Okay, so that was a decent merchant. It was a pretty... pretty good merchant, I'd say. Not like super fast, but pretty decent. Oh, the Craigasms. Del Lago. I can't remember if I get the good Del Lago on this one or not. That's another thing, like, I know how to do. I don't get it, like, 100% every time, but, like, if I get him to do the pattern where, you know, you're about to go for the sixth hit type of thing, there's a trick that you can do for new game, because you need 12 hits rather than 10. So, like, you can, if you hold right longer than you should, he will normally dive the good way for you. Alright, so we need this crow splash for the water hall using the no leave strat. So I grab that. But yeah, with the Lago, normally you would want to, like, you wait for a second, and then as soon as he comes up for that sixth hit, you want to, like, aim up pretty quick so that way you can get, like, the 10 hits. But instead, if you hold right for a long time and wait for him to come up out of the water and then go for 6, 7, 8, 9, he'll normally do a good dive for you, and you can just, like, turn around 11, 10, 11, 12 right there. So I don't remember if I get it on this one or not, but, like, if I do, I'll point it out. It's really nifty, though. So, shoot these tripwires. Run past the gang. Also, someone really needs to, like, you know, 60 FPS is being improved, like, big time right now with, like, Morris and Pitted, but, like, no one is working on this, and this should be, like, a piece of cake to beat. Just takes patience, which I don't have, apparently. Going to the grocery store. 30 pack of Keystone Light, I don't know. Yeah, it is. I actually do that now. But once again, this is like 2.5 weeks ago and I didn't do that, so. So let's see what I do on Delago. I can't remember what kind of pattern he gives me on this run. This is the first time I've watched this run since I actually just did the run by itself. Like, I'm watching it for the first time, pretty much, as you guys are. Okay, so he gave me the bad pattern. If he gives you that good pattern, though, I wish I could have shown you. I've got videos of it, though. And I'm also going to make a tutorial, so. But yeah, you just hold right for a really, really long time. Even after he's out of the water, you keep holding it. So obviously, you know, you lose a lot of time whenever he just dives and you don't get the, I tried for the fourth hit. Couldn't get it, though. It's Keystone. Yeah, see, look at the time. Look at, you can't see it, the time loss, though. Like, it was, like, I lost, let's see. Like, 12 seconds, I think. That's crazy. I think I'm gonna add, hold on, I'm gonna try and add the splits for you guys as well, just so you can see them. So let me go window capture. Capture the same thing, and then I'll just crop it out. So, like, this way you can see, like, where I'm at in these, like, this really crappy time that I have. let's see, where would be a good place to put this, you guys? Is this a good spot, you think? Is that good enough? All right. Yeah. Yep. Okay, it's good. And like I said, it's using the auto splitter, so it's all like game time, in game time. Not real time. So, like, every split's always a even number because the game either rounds up or rounds down, depending. So, unfortunately, I wasted too many shots before I got to this part, so I had to reload here, which, you know, if you're playing good, you won't have to do that, but I wasn't. So I had to reload there. You want to be, like, going into this section with, like, you know, 5 bullets if you're, like, doing good, pretty much. I'm not a pussy, and I just do the skip because, like, there's no point to, like, not, like, to go hit the switch. That just takes way too much time. It's like, you might as well just do it. Like, it took me a second to line it up, too. Like, at this point, I was still kind of trying to get used to the new game style of doing the waterfall. Now I can do it, like, way faster. Like, I know exactly where I need to line up and stuff, but... What's up, Blizzard? So, just a little backstory on this, on, like, the strats and stuff that I use. Like, some of them aren't perfected at this point. Like, drove you nuts. Alright, Saint Killer, joke's getting old, man. Joke's getting old. So, Carpenter and I, both New Game Plus runners, went through and watched, like, a crap ton of New Game Pro runs. Took all the best strats we could think of together and, like, tried to make... it's a fairly ballsy... I don't know, fairly ballsy run, but... it's not, like, super crazy segmented. It's still SS strats. It's just, like, the most dangerous SS strats, probably. There's probably a couple more that, like... I chose not to do that are just like, wow, that's really, really, really ballsy that maybe some other people do. But we'll get to those whenever I see them, if I see them anyways. I don't know what that means, but okay, thank you. I don't know, like my setup for, like, reviewing runs, or what? I don't know. So for, like, my incendiaries, oh yeah, that was so stupid. Like, usually it's money. If you open that second barrel, it's usually money, and it surprised me. I was like, oh, handgun ammo, cool. Like, but the incendiaries that I go for, like, I go for the one in the tree rather than the one in the house. And then the church one. Those are the two that I choose. Because I believe those are the two fastest. I know Pharaoh likes to go for the one in the house. It's a lot safer, but I think it's slower. But who knows? One of us needs to really go time that. Really need to time those. Camera's the same. The mic I'm borrowing from my roommate. It's a Blue Yeti mic, which I'll be buying one eventually. But for now, I'm just using his because he's not using it, so. Oh, so you don't go for the one in the church. That's different. Okay, so something that I didn't do there, which I actually do every time now, is as soon as I open that door... I probably have a video. I could probably show you guys. But what I do every time now is as soon as I open that door, as soon as I come out, I do wait, follow me. And then when I'm going around the bear trap, I hug the right as much as I can. And what this does is the guy that is... Let me see. Let me go back. So I'll try and, like, point him out. So the guy that's on the left... What will happen, like, literally every time, is he will run at you, and as long as you just stay to the right, the other guy who's in front of you will point. So, wait, follow me right here. At this point, I do a wait, follow me now. Stay to the right. And then you see this, like, there's a guy running towards me right now. See that guy right there to my left? Basically, this setup will happen every time. Me and Carpenter found this out. So, if you do that, like, it'll pretty much work every time, just like it is right now. Except I didn't actually do the strat of wait, follow me. So. Alright, so this guy ran, which is good. If that guy doesn't run, that really screws you. I don't think I did wait follow me right there either. Before I go up the ladder now, I do a wait follow me so that these people... Yeah. At this point, I didn't know, like, to use that. So, at the bottom of the ladder, do wait follow me, and then those guys will move over to the left. So that way you don't get hit. That guy was in a weird position. Usually he's more to the right. That was kind of... kind of crazy. Yeah, your flash grenades, I got you. Alright, so cabin is literally the same every time. It's just a matter of, like, if the game likes you or not. That's all there is to it. I shot up there because sometimes there's a guy right outside the window and, like, wow, I did not know I killed that guy. What? How did I kill that guy? Also, I don't run over here anymore. I run straight at Lewis and do a turnaround. So, that's different. It doesn't really do anything different, but I mean... I guess it changes his position. His position is, like, a little different if you run at him and turn around.
Are you trying to kill me?
Yeah, somehow my knife didn't hit him there, which was... kind of cool. I don't know. I saw he got grabbed pretty early, so I just went ahead and threw it. And then I wait for these guys. And I feel like I shouldn't throw grenades. Also, I don't combine the green herb, just so I'll have two healing items in the cabin. This way I have two. I feel like we shouldn't throw that grenade out that window. I feel like you don't kill that many people. But if you were to throw it out one of the other windows, I feel like you would kill more. Or just keep it and wait until you're on the stairs. And do it. I don't know, because like I feel like that window does not give you that many kills. Maybe that's just me. So literally this part is just like... you just wait. Like, I really hate this part of the cabin. It's just so boring. You're sitting here waiting, like, hoping that it'll go good. That's if they're spawned correctly. There's been times where I've thrown it out there and I don't hear anyone. Like, I don't hear anyone get hit. Literally zero. And I'm just like, oh. So at that point, I got a glod. Cabin, because it was the first time I think the game had ever given me a good one.
Follow me.
So, that's why I saved 21 seconds on that, just because the game decided to give it to me. So that's cool. So, I don't like switch the grenade and run here. Some people do. Like, I don't see the point. I don't think it's faster. Like, I don't think there's enough space in between, like, you, like, switching to the grenade and running through all this for it to count, because you gotta switch here anyways to this. I don't know. It could be tested. So, I'm gonna skip through the gondola because there's nothing special there. All I do is switch to the incendiary and run down here. Gondola's the same for everyone. You can't, like, do anything different there. There's just nothing. There, I only grab TMP ammo because you don't need the handgun or shotgun ammo at this point. Unless you really are needing it, like, strapping for cash. Like, oh man, maybe this extra $200 is gonna help me. You know, from selling the ammo, but I don't know when you would need that less of amount of money. Why would you not just grab some more money, you know? But you're not going to need it, so just grab the TMP ammo. Big cheese fight. Yep, no elevator strats. Yeah, I got hit by the fire there, which is kind of unfortunate. Okay, this part, when I throw that fourth grenade, I don't do a turnaround anymore. I do a quick turn left and rub against the wall, and for some reason it seems like every time he gives me the fast pattern now. Like, he jumps up real quick and comes over here real quick. So, I started doing that instead of doing a turnaround. This is going to be a lot of running. I'm just going to skip this. Because running is just super boring. Alright, so at this point, like, I shoot the truck. Then I move my flash grenade over to the right. And also equip it. Also, at that door, I forgot to combine my herb with the red and yellow, so I can't remember if I do it before the merchant or if I just completely forget, because if I forget, this may be the run where I messed up really bad on the inventory, but I can't remember. We'll see. So I move that over and equip it. Yeah, see, okay, I completely forgot then. That's bad. I was supposed to do it at that door. But that was just an experience and me only playing it four times, or three times before. I don't grab the money there because I don't need the TMP stock. I don't use the TMP stock, there's no point. Okay, I remembered. Nice, I remembered. Wait. Too bad it cost me time, but cost me like a second or two. What are you selling? So I started to go down and sell the shotgun and handgun, but then I was like, oh yeah, I gotta sell the ammo first. This is still me, just being inexperienced. So this is a really sloppy merchant. And there we go. So at this point, I go with no healing items. There's no point in buying one, that takes time. There's no point in grabbing one off the table. You don't need it. At this point, I think I went to the bathroom, so we're gonna skip. Okay. There we go. I never was in the stock club. I always started in the stock club, son. There's no point to having it. There's really not. It just takes up room in your inventory and doesn't really help. Yeah, somehow I miss. And then I get him. So, I don't know where everyone places Ashley, but this is where I place Ashley. Wait. Place her right there. And I tell her to follow me right before I turn the corner. Or like as I'm turning the corner. She'll usually get grabbed when I'm like, when the cannon is like right here. Just like that. And that's like perfect because you want her to get grabbed even on like New Game Plus, because she spawns in a good spot for you rather than being like right in front of your face where you can't even move. And I tell her to wait. Okay, this next room, I don't think I actually do the strat, but I came up with a strat and it works literally like 100% of the time. I don't think I've ever had it mess up since I started using it. But basically in this next room, when you run up the stairs, there's a part on the wall. It's like a visual cue for me. I run up and I tell Ashley to wait at that point. When I tell her to wait, it alerts the guys, but they don't like run. They like walk still. So I go grab the first one, come down, tell her to follow me, turn, and then here's the trick. Here's the kicker. The kicker's like, you know, telling her to wait at a certain spot, and then also, like, once you grab the second sword, to do a quick turn to the right. And for some reason, they get, like, stuck on the table. And then, like, no guys ever get near you. It's a little strat that works for me. I've gotten it to work every time. And then Carpenter tried on the 360, and it worked for him. I don't think I do it in this run, but I can show you guys at a later point. So, let me see what I do here.
Wait.
Okay, so I think I told her to wait too late. It looked like it. No, okay, it may be good. Let's see if I do the quick turn, though. I can't remember if I knew it at this point or not. Okay, I did. Sweet. You see how this works? This works literally, like, every time, dude. Every time this works. What's up, Snow?
Wait.
Okay, so you gotta remember, at this point, I still have no herb. And there's no point in grabbing this herb either, because if you get a hit here, it's the run's over anyways. So there's no point in grabbing it, that just wastes time. Okay, here's another neat little trick that I like to do. As soon as you bust this door open... Yeah, dude, take some notes, please. Please take my strats and become good. Like, really, really good with them. Like, I want to see them, like, do good. Anyways, bust this door open and immediately shoot one shot. This one shot will alert the guys, and usually they'll run at you. They'll run at you at such an angle that you can move to the right and not get hit. I can't remember if I do it here and if it works. So shoot once, move forward a little bit, and then, yeah. Normally those guys, like all three of them, will run at you, but that one guy decided not to, so. But normally all three will run at you, and then you can just, like, whoop, like right past them. If one of them doesn't, you just gotta shoot them like I did. That handgun ammo, you don't need that. I had to pick it up because it was in front of the door, so I just got rid of it. Okay, get ready for some hilariousness. At this point, I still didn't have the guard or strat, like, completely optimized. I had it, like, maybe 80%, you know? Now I realize that, like, what I did wrong here after I saw this was I walked back too much. So I always use that. I always grab that incendiary there. But basically what happens is I try and do the fast guard or strat, and like before I get the third shot, I walk back too far and too quickly. Like I needed to stop, and you basically have to be like inside of the guard, or you have to be like really inside of his hitbox, where it's like you can see through him almost eventually. And now that I know that, I do it, but like I didn't here, so. So right here, after you hit this, you gotta walk back just a little bit and like kind of wait a second so he'll do a turnaround. And I did it too quickly, so. And I was like, oh well. And I was like, you know what? Let's just try to hit him in the back for fun. And I was like, oh, I missed. Oh, I missed again. I was like, oh, it's over. So I just restarted. I was like, screw it. So this time he doesn't turn around, but I'm still too far back. And as you can see, I didn't hit the plaga. But I got lucky enough to where I was inside of him for that last hit that it went through and actually hit the plaga, so I got lucky there. That incendiary, I forgot to grab. And it doesn't really affect anything, except for, like, yeah, I was trying to avoid that plaga too. But what I like to have is I like to have that incendiary. I always have an extra one, and it's the very end. The reason I have this extra one is it's for a running grenade. In 5-4, I end up using all of my grenades, because you use an incendiary on the turret there. I use an incendiary on the red Zealot, and I also use an incendiary in 4-1 by the Queen's and King's Grail area. So I end up using 3, but I have 4 during the run, and that one right there is like, you know, that's why I needed that one, so I could have one in the end, so I could use it as a running grenade. But I don't have it on this run, so I end up just using the rocket launcher, because it's hands-free, you know? Okay, so this water hall is janky. Like, it's good until the end. And then it's just like, what? So I always shoot that guy down. I know you can run past him.
Welcome.
But it seems to... I heard something.
Tiger Woods fan just followed. Hello. Hey.
Thank you.
Wait.
But yeah, I always shoot that guy down because... It just seems to work better, like where he's positioned. And then also, I didn't throw that grenade high enough, and this is why this happens right here. Like, that guy is tricky to flash. Like, he'll be in a little corridor on the right, and if you don't throw that flash up high enough, he won't get flashed. And that's what happened, was I didn't throw it, like, way up there. So now I have to, like, run back here and freaking save Ashley. And then somehow, like, these two guys didn't get flashed because the crank was, like, blocking the flash somehow. But I'm able to get through. So I'm like, okay, we're fine. I wasted a lot of seconds doing all that, but, like, it's better than losing a run, right? So that's kind of how I feel about it. So then the rest of this, I don't know if the rest of this is good or bad. We'll find out. Can't remember what happens on this water hall. That's nice. I like that miss. I think I still get to him in time. Yeah. If you miss once, you're still okay. You don't want to miss, just for the fact that, like, you know, it doesn't give you that much time to set up and shoot those guys. But you always want to make sure you get that double headshot, and your game runner will tell you that, I know, for a fact. Okay, so I tried to reload there. That's why I was staying scoped in. I remember I was just, like, holding down. I was, like, hitting A. I was like, oh, yeah, I forget this takes forever. So normally you would want to, like, unscope and then try and reload. At this point... I mess up here, I remember this. So I'm looking for Usain Bolt. And that was, like, way too late. Like, I should have hit him. What I do now is, like, whenever I bust the vase open to grab this incendiary that I have, I wait at the vase and shoot him from really, really far back, like JTB does. And that seems to work. Like, he's always in a good position and you're able to hit him. I think I may get to Ashley late now because of that. Let's find out. Oh no, I'm gonna get there. Never mind. Okay. So we're good. We're fine. Well, the key, Pharaoh, is to just not miss. It's all good, man. Just don't miss. But, I mean, I see what you mean, but, like, I don't understand, like, five extra shots? Do you really need five extra, Pharaoh? You're better than that. I know you are. I know you don't use that ammo every time. There's no way. There's no way you use that ammo every time. So, as you can see, I'm losing a lot of time on this split just because, like, the guard door. And also that jank water hall part where I had to go, like, run back for Ashley. Okay, this flash right here. Like, if you do the no leave, then you need it. But if you do the leave, you don't need it. I did the no leave, so I needed it. I don't remember what happens on this, this first layer. I got past that first hit. That was good. I was lucky. Got past that guy. Nice. If I'm gonna take any hit, I would rather be a claw and just hope you don't get decapitated, but dropkick second best, so I guess that's cool.
Now you can get rid of Ashley.
Yeah, exactly. Like, the sections of the game where you don't have Ashley are, like,
a breath of fresh air.
Alright, good pattern on the guillotines. That's nice. If you did the leave strat, me and Carpenter figured out a way to do a leave strat where, like, we go into the water hall still having three grenades as if we're going to do a no leave. But, we only use one in the leave strat. So we still have two. And we only really need one. So then whenever that cutscene comes up, we do a, we throw a flash because it saves 6 seconds. So we just waste that flash and save the 6 seconds. Also, that inventory was... The inventory was messed up, I think, because I didn't grab that other incendiary outside of guard door, because when I reset, I forgot to grab it, you know? So that's why. It was all janked up. Ricky Bobby! Sometimes you can get it to where you can kill him with two hits. I've had that happen a couple times, but I don't know what the secret is to getting it. Maybe Pharaoh knows. Okay, I usually grab that herb, like, no matter what. My rule of thumb, normally, is if I have... Oh, nice. If I have, two heals, then I'm fine. But I was planning on, like, combining those later, and I just didn't get the chance, so... So I went ahead and just wasted a lot of shots there because I knew I would need to reload anyways before I did, like, the lock in the guard door area and stuff. So I just, like, yeah, screw it, I'll just waste some here just because I can. Yeah, there's no way to increase it to exclusive with the strapped amount of cash we have, though. We don't upgrade any weapon, actually. There's no weapon that we upgrade. So I always grab this because I use that one for the 1 and 4-1 in the King and Queen's Grail hallway. Normally on New Game Plus we'd use a regular grenade or the PRL, but, you know, on this it's just easier to do the incendiary because you get more of those than regular grenades. So the maze I'm going to skip because there's nothing here. It's just running through the maze. I mean, that's, you know, just whatever. And it says, like, I lost a lot of time, and I think it's just because I don't know, actually. Well, it would have been the bugs. It would have been that and... What else happened? I don't even know. Oh, getting grabbed in that other part, too. So I went ahead and wasted my shots here to reload. Grab that. Got lucky that guy didn't swing at me with the mace. Like, normally you want that guy to go down. Unless he's in front of the door, then you can, So I got the 1-2-3, which was really good there. I don't know either. That's why, like I said, me and Carpenter picked all the best strats and basically tried to put them together, so... You know, from a New Game Plus standpoint, we already do it, so we're like, why wouldn't we use it, you know? Like, it's better. You have way less of a chance of getting hit. It's, like, faster than the other strat, I'm pretty sure. Like, I don't understand why people don't do it. So I always try for the double shot on that, but rarely get that ever. I do a turnaround there instead of a quick turn now. I think that was just me trying out the quick turn. I think I had done the turnaround every other time. I was like, let's just see what a quick turn does, if it's faster or not, but it's not. Not any better. I can't open it. I was kind of mixed up, like, I didn't know where my grenade was there for a second. This is just all because my inventory is messed up from not grabbing that one incendiary. At this point, I don't know why I chose to reload my sniper and run with it. Like, I don't do that anymore. I just run like normal until I get to the part where I need to snipe and switch to it. Shoot that guy, you know. So I don't know why I did it there. Ashley's section I'm going to skip. There's nothing here. Nothing in Ashley. Killed Ashley. Nothing wrong with killing Ashley. One of my favorite pastimes. If you guys have any comments or like disagreements with like some of these strats that I've been using, please let me know. Obviously, you can take it or leave it when it comes to strats, you know, especially these, because they're like no one else does them like combined this way anyways, so that's why I'm showing you this. But I don't know, I mean, I found success in 4 runs with them, so I guess they work, right? Alright, so I always switch to TMP there just because you're gonna need it for the Queen's Grail later, and then you need it just in case this guy comes up on you, which most of the time he will. Even if you run in that little cubby hole, he'll still like usually come after you. There's a chance that he'll do the little turnaround and not come after you, but like probably like 90% of the time he's gonna walk over there, so you're gonna be able to shoot him or dodge him somehow. The knights, yeah, dude, the Armaduro's room is still probably the worst. Like, that's probably, like, the scariest moment. Like, just, you're trapped in a room, and there's, like, these guys coming at you, and they're pretty fast. I mean, like, they walk slow, but, like, there's not enough room for you to get away, so it seems like they're just always on you. You're like, oh my god, like, it's terrible. Yeah, I mean, like, what's the point when... I mean, I guess you could always switch to the TMP at this point, but, like, why not just switch and already have it out? It's just one less switch that you have to do, and it's more guaranteed because you can just shoot them. But that's just me. All right, good, because, yeah, I want to start that. Yeah, and whenever you barely have ammo, yeah, the knights are terrible. Terrible. Okay, so next is... Okay, I remember this. I aim, like, really horribly trying to shoot the guys. And that's just because, like, I wasn't experienced enough with using the TMP at this point to shoot them. But now I can get them in, like, you know, 2 or 3 pops. It's just like, doop, doop, okay, we're done. Like, but on this one, I remember I, like, sucked hard. Wow. See, look how bad I sucked with the TMP at this point. But now I'm like... Now I'm way more accurate with it. I'm way more accurate with it now that I've just played with it more. So yeah, I take forever on this part. It's hard to see that freaking... Like, you can't even see the aim. You're just, like, shooting blindly, kind of. But now I know, like, where, like... the camera position needs to be for me to be able, like, oh, I know I'm on their level now, you know? So you just can't see the reticle at all. So this is a Morris Strat right here grabbing the herb. I'm not sure if he came up with it, but that's where I found it. And I asked him the reason why he did it, because me and Carpenter were trying to figure out, like, why the heck does he grab a yellow herb for him? It's not, like, we tried to test it to see if it was because if you get hit by, what was it? If you get hit, like, by a scythe, maybe you can live. That's what we thought it was, but apparently it's for the Novistadors. The reason we grab the yellow herb to use is because you can take 3 hits from, or like you can take 2 hits from the Novistadors and live instead of taking 2 and die. So like you'll have a sliver of health left if you get hit twice by using the yellow herb. That's why he uses it, and that's why we use it too. We're like, you know what, why not? It's right there, let's just grab it. So I grabbed the shotgun shells and the herb in here. The 2 herbs. So now I have, like, you know, a pretty good amount of heals right now. One of them I'm about to use. You got to use the yellow herb one before you even get to the second layer of hell. So I'll have 2 heals still, though, going in. So that's pretty good. Yep. Slow nights, yes. Hey, you got to remember, man, this was only my 4th run. Give me some slack, you. So somehow I was able to get all of them with that. Normally I don't get all of them. So I used the yellow herb already. Switch to my flash here. I only use 1 flash. Some people use 2 on the Novistadors. I only use 1. Because, yeah. The people want RE5. What people? What do you mean, you people? So the trick here is to just like stay up against this left wall for as long as you possibly can and stay really far left, and then you hope that it'll work. One on the side survives. Yeah, I know. That's why I normally try and throw it on the left side, Pharaoh. Like, if I aim up, I'll aim, like, just like a sliver to the left to make sure I get that guy rather than the right guy, because the first one I go for is the Queen's Grill since it's the first one in the inventory. So I do that one, and then I leave Ashley on that left side, knowing that the guy who's left is on the right side, so he won't come and grab Ashley. So Clock Tower, I feel like I should skip Clock Tower. I mean, there's nothing here, but we'll watch it. Dead Rising, it's not my wallet. RE5, yeah, we're going to try to put RE5 into AGDQ. We submitted it for SGDQ, it didn't get accepted, but maybe this time it will. We'll see what happens. I kind of forgot that I like promised Snow that we would do a new game segmented run, so that's the next thing I have to do instead of starting Korra. But that's, I'm fine with that. I'm cool with that because I had already promised it, so I can't go back on that, you know. Plus, it's not new game RE4, so I'm definitely fine with that. So I do the Pharaoh reload there. Instead of shooting it, and like I decided to run that way, so I just decided, I don't know how I'd live that. Like, I should have got hit by that. That was really close. That was like super close. Okay, this is hilarious. I tried the rookie rocket, and I hit the guy. So I was like, ah, now I gotta freaking restart. And so I try it again, right? And then it doesn't work at all. And I was like, you know what? F it. I'm just gonna shoot the guy. Like, two failed Ricky Rockets just because I didn't feel like doing it. I was just like, whatever, dude. Like, F this. I'm just gonna shoot him. Like, so that was a good time waste right there. How many seconds was that? 10 seconds I just wasted for fun? Cool. The PRL. I should have used the PRL. It's funny. Alright, do I grab... Okay, see, I don't do this anymore either.
Welcome.
I actually go... I grab the crown. Then I go to the merchant first. Sell my stuff, buy the stuff, come out, turn left, grab the ammo, turn right, grab the incendiary, dipping up the ladder. The reason I do this is it's better for my inventory. It makes it to where the magnum ammo is like right next to the TMP, which is where I need it later because I put it right next to the Killer 7. So I don't actually grab those items first anymore.
What are you selling? What are you buying? Thank you. Come. Back anytime.
What even is that face thing that you put on there? I can't even tell what that is. It looks like... it's like a different version of Poof from Fairly Odd Parents. Just like a person with a completely circular body. That's what it looks like anyways. I don't know. Like, what are you? What even are you? Nothing special with Vertigo. The only thing I like to do, I don't even know if I do it on this one, we'll see, but I like to, once I hit this door, I walk for a second to ensure that he won't, like, do a QTE. Okay, so see how I walk for, like, half a second? Yeah. It's just so that he won't, like, do a QTE immediately and just, like, work me. Yeah, and I was too close there. Like, normally, he doesn't, like, run that fast towards me. Normally, he runs, but, like, I'm able to, like, just turn, and he's still behind the fence over there. So I don't know what happened there. He was just, like, super fast on me that time. It happens every once in a while, but rarely for me anyways. Found my hoodie. Yeah, I've seen that. Yep. Wow, look at that split though. I don't understand what I did on my other runs. I must have like, because there were no reset runs, so obviously lots of things probably went wrong. I bet Armadillos went wrong. I bet second layer went wrong. There's a lot of things in 4-1 that can actually go wrong. So. This part. So in the Gigante room, no, I don't do anything in there. In the end of this room, I grab a grenade. I know what it is. Okay. Remember how I was saying there's some strats that are like really ballsy that like I don't do? One of them is in 4-4 that I don't do, and it's just because like I don't know. It's easier to do it this other way, and it only loses you maybe like 3 or 4 seconds total. But you're like guaranteed to get the room done. I'm talking about the statue room. Like I grabbed that grenade for that statue room later, instead of using the TMP, which like I've done before. It's just like it's, I don't know. Like there's been times where I'll still get hit doing that, but if I do the grenade strat, I'm usually good, so... yeah. No, F the flash, dude.
Yeah. Yeah, dude. This layer of hell is probably actually the easiest one, in my opinion. This one is by far the easiest one. Believe it or not. Sleepwalker taught us that trick right there. Like on New Game Plus, we always take the left side. We take the left wall. And we hug it super hard and look to the left. Sleepwalker taught us that on New Game, if you run to the right and then come out of the cave and keep going like forward and take like a really big arc, like a real wide turn, and look to the right the whole time, that like for some reason the guys just like don't ever hit you. So we're like, well, F it, we don't need a flash then, like we don't even need that flash. And it's worked like every time. So that was one of the Sleepwalker strats that we stole. And like you'll see, like even on my no reset runs, like my splits here, I think I actually lose time on this split, just because like every single time I get that no vista door trick to happen. So it's ridiculous. Yeah, see? Lost 2 seconds. It's ridiculous. Because that trick works pretty much every time. I would say probably like... Oh yeah, I think I go... I think I had like laundry this day. Take a really long break here, if I remember right. Yep, okay. Let's go back. Alright, here we go. I don't know, the RE5 like community, like me and Snow just got moderator in RE5 for speedrun.com, but we're not really, I don't know. I grabbed this flash because, like, I don't grab the one in Gigante Room, but I grabbed the one here. Gigante Room takes longer than it does to grab this one, so that's why I grabbed this one. But yeah, for RE5, like, me and Snow, even though we have, like, Snow's probably the best player in the world at RE5, and, like, me and him have really good times, I don't think they, like, really consider us, like, the people to, like, dictate stuff like that yet. It's basically a Trance and, like, Xenix. So you'd have to ask them. So I always wait to grab the key before I do Dimmon, just because, like, there is a possibility that if you do Dimmon immediately, the Chainsaw guy will wreck you, because you're, like, right next to him. Okay, at this point, I mess up super hard right here. The reason I mess up super hard right here is because, like, we had just figured out that, like, we needed to do this. Like, me and Carpenter had just figured out that we needed to sell, like, combine the crown before we sold it. So, I was worried, like, in my head, like, okay, I need to remember. And I was, like, having to, like, really focus, like, as soon as I got into this chapter, like, oh, remember to sell the crown. And because I did that, I forgot to equip the striker first. And then I, like, jacked up the inventory, like, super hard, and I, like, could not get it back. Like, I was, like, trying to get back to the weapons, and I just couldn't do it, and, like, took me forever. Oh, okay. Here you guys go. Here's a strat that I made up. I've never seen anyone else do this. I could be wrong. Someone else may have already done this, but this is a new strat that I completely made myself. Just watch this this bug room. I walk in, Dimmon, shoot 2, run forward, turn around, shoot 1, walk backwards like a little bit, and like what this will do is make it to where like if one of the bugs is going to jump, or both the bugs if they're going to jump, if you walk backwards they'll always miss you, and they take forever to jump again, so you have time to shoot the 4th one. So just watch this room. This is one I completely made up. So someone use that. Someone use that. Go on. Do it. Do the Audi room. The Audi bug. What do we call it? the Audi Indiana Jones room. I don't know. Just do that strat. It's cool. It works.
Well, it wouldn't count. Yeah.
You're right, Snow. I mean, you would think. But you know how those communities are. Like, oh, if we don't have a run, we don't have, if we don't have a video, ugh. You know how they are. Buggity. Nice. I'll take it. Oh, man. Find a quote from Indiana Jones. Okay, let's... I can't remember if I do the Ricky Plank or not. We're gonna find out. Nope. Okay. I took it safe. I'm a scrub. I took it safe. Okay, so normally, now what I do is I shoot the two guys off the right like I did, but I also shoot that other guy on the left. I didn't on this one. The reason is you don't need anything from him, and that way he's not on your cart, like, messing you up. So I shoot three of them and leave only the chainsaw guy now. So that's different from this run. So that you don't have to do all this mess right here. You can just worry about this guy. Rubik's Cube. Nice. So I knew the chainsaw guy was about to get up. I was like, yeah, I'm just going to get out of here. Like, let him hit the plank instead. Oh, how did I live? It like would not give me a jump over. It would not give me a jump over. I got so lucky. Oh my god, what the heck was that, yo? Wow. That was insane. So much stuff. Picking up so much stuff, yo. I don't get boyfriend percent on this one because I was way too slow. I'm so sorry, Pidgeot. I'm so sorry. Like, at this point, I really didn't even have the minecart down yet. Now I do, obviously, but... 21 seconds. Oh, so... Also, chapter 5-3. Just get ready for the hype in 5-3. Because today I'm going to reveal my newest strat that is used on both New Game Plus and New Game. It is called the Audi Statue. If you guys thought my statue was good before, it's even better now. So, yeah. Get ready for the hype. Okay, so I do the grenade strat in here. Okay, shoot there. And I should shoot here. I'll see if I remember. I don't. Okay. Normally I shoot at the bottom of that ladder now, which alerts this guy. But I didn't, because I'm stupid. I can't remember if I hit myself here. I do, because I'm so good. If you jump too early, that's what happens. And I remember doing that, so. Normally, I would just be running with, like, nothing right now. I would have, you know, nothing in my hand. And then I would knife the lock at the end. That's what I normally do. But obviously, I messed this room up, like, really hard, so. And then these guys, you know, obviously. So yeah, this room was god-awful. Oh my gosh, get ready for the most disappointing elevator you'll ever see in your life. Like, I do the Morris strat now. where, like, you walk forward a little bit, then turn around and shoot, walk forward, turn around and shoot, walk forward. You just keep doing that. And, like, I know the amount of distance that I need now because I've done it so many more times, but at this point I didn't know how to do it, and I got destroyed. I get destroyed on the elevator. It's so bad. It's so bad. It's like nice. Somehow I didn't get that. It's cool. Oh, get ready for some get welded. I need the get welded emotes in here. So that was good. That's a good lineup right there. That'll work. But I think what happens is I don't walk enough forward here in a second. And that's what screws me. Yeah, I just do a turnaround. Yeah, they're behind me. Yeah, no. That's where it all left up. I didn't even walk forward at all. So. Yep. So there's a good, I don't know how many seconds. How many seconds you think? And then I mess up this elevator too, man. I mess up this one too. Like, this is what happens when you don't know how to do elevator. Oh, I'm way too far forward. Look at that. I'm way too far forward. What am I doing with my life? I was so bad. I was so bad then, dude. I was so bad. That's what I'm saying, Pitted. Like, JTB's time is, like, actually really easy to beat, dude. Like, you guys should be able to beat it super easy. Like, people that do runs constantly and can actually, like, you know, go with, like, being patient with it. Because I can't do this. I can't be... I'm not patient enough for this. Like, the 30 FPS record should be at least, like, a minute faster or more. It should be a 138 something easy. Yeah, I did the D-cross too. I do it too. Now. I did some here too. You may not have seen it, but I did. So that elevator was also god-awful, so there you go. Silky smooth. Yes. The silkiest. Like, quite literally, I could have beaten the world record with this fourth run of mine if I had done, like, a good guard door and a good elevator. Literally, I could have beaten the world record on my fourth attempt ever. That's so weird to think about. Because, like, look how much time I'm losing right now. It's so funny. Have fun killing Salazar. Oh my gosh, look at this time loss. I love it, dude. So good. Also, I did not mean to sell that stuff there. Like, you can sell it here, but I normally sell it now at the merchant right before I'm about to grab the killer 7. And rocket in 5-3. So, like, that was just me being stupid and thinking, like, oh man, I need to sell this, because at this point I had still had it in my mind, like, oh yeah, I combined the crown. It was like the combining of the crown was like a big thing to me, you know? And so, like, I was like, oh, I need to sell it, but, like, I don't really need to sell it until I'm actually in a sell menu, and I don't go to a sell menu at that point. I just buy stuff there. The next time you sell anything is at the Merchant of 5-3, so that's when I should have done it, and that's when I do it now. But, you know, it's whatever. 5-1. Do I do anything in 5-1 that's different? No, I don't know. The boulder skip? It's a big thing. It's always been a big thing on GameCube and TSC because we need it. Nowhere else, though. Not even the new one. The new one's not really applicable to new game either. Unless you do a segmented run. If you do a segmented run, then it's applicable. Not for SS, dude. There's no way. So, yep. What is the cheater, double cheater part about Pharaoh? Just the fact that I almost got the world record? And I barely played the category? Is that what you're talking about? Or what? Or the fact that I did the Salazar skip and then the Island skip, because those are, you know, those are cheats, too. I don't know what you're talking about, so. You could skip Salazar money. Yeah, I mean, like, you could skip a lot of things, but it's, like, it's too hard to get in an SS run. That's what I figured. Was the glitches, that's kind of what I figured. I just didn't know, I was like, what are you talking about? Nice. Yeah, in my opinion, Morris is probably the best new game runner out there. He is the best one. That's what I call the Audi puzzle. Super sexy fast, yeah. You're on Team Pharaoh? See, no offense, Pharaoh, but I think Morris is the best new game runner in the world. Second place is probably you, Pharaoh. Third's probably, it's probably Pitted. Trying to think of all the new game runners. Then probably JTB after that. I don't consider myself a new game runner, so I'm not going to put myself anywhere. Who else? Who else is doing stuff right now? Koro does new game, Naruto does new game. I don't know. It'd be cool to see you guys race. Too bad you're on different consoles. Pharaoh and Morris, I feel like that'd be a really good race, dude. Yeah, that's one of the reasons I think Morris is the best, is because he's so consistent. So. So normally I don't grab that flash beforehand anymore, I always do it after. Reason being, like, I don't know what my inventory looks like every time at this point with heals, so, like, I wait till my rocket's gone and then pick it up. That way I know for sure I have room. That's the only reason I wait now. I don't know if that's why you guys always waited too, but that's the reason I do. Dude, that's what I'm talking about, Pitted. Like, Free World Records is where it's at. I know all about that, dude. Like, Free World Records is fun. Like, go find, like, really obscure ones. Just get the world record. It's simple. Like, Sleepwalker has the record for Soma right now just because, like, no one else has done it. It's like, hey, you got a world record, so let's do it. Wow, that time save, the 26 seconds. You don't have to record it to be able to race. As long as, like, you have, like, a picture or something of it, then just whatever. PS3? What's wrong with you?
What is that thing?
PlayStation controllers suck, dude. terrible. I hate them. Wait, follow, wait, follow, wait, follow. They're pretty much only good for RPGs. You know why? Because all you have to do is just like click a few buttons here and there. Nothing else. Is that in-game time or real time? Okay, this room. I need to talk about this room. At this point, I have 3 flashes, because I use 3 flashes in this room. However, I know you can get by with 2 flashes. But the 3rd flash would be used on those guys I just shot with the shotgun. So my question is, how did you guys do the room with flashing the big guy and the other 2 guys, then jumping down to the actual wrecking ball area and using 2 flashes in there? Do you do Dittman? Do you... Like, what's the best way of doing it? Because I wanted to learn that. That's one of the strats that's, like, a risky strat that I didn't actually learn. Because shooting the guys and having to switch back to a grenade is really slow. So this is one of the risky strats that I never actually learned. I never took the time to learn it. So I didn't have time to implement it in my short new game career. So there you go. So I end up just, like, using all 3 in here like I do every time now. So you guys do Dittman. Okay. This room was really slow, just for the fact that I had to do that. But I'm pretty sure... Yeah, I throw that one just to be safe. I'm pretty sure the rest of my chapter 5 is just like complete sex, though. Like, I'm pretty sure everything else goes, like, according to plan. Wait. Which is funny, like, my chapter 5, like, a lot of people, I mean a lot of people, have been able to race without a stream. You don't have to stream to be able to race, that's what I'm saying. Like, on SRL, you can have, like, a picture, as long as you have proof of some sort that the run happened, then, like, we can race. It doesn't matter. Like, we can even just take your word. If you want to just, like, Skype race with us, I mean, we could just do that. Like, you know, it didn't even have to be a big deal. Just for fun, right? But yeah, like everyone, it seems like everybody who does new game has trouble with chapter 5. And like, I don't know if it's because I'm a new game plus runner and like I'm so used to using Dittman and like other things and like just the way it works and the fact that I practice the shat out of Chapter 5 for that Illuminati versus Sunblade relay race, because that was my chapter. I like played the crap out of it, that I know it's so good now that like it's basically just like second nature, even if it's a new game run. I don't know if that's why, but like it seems like my chapter 5s, no matter if I get basically if I can get past chapter 4-4, like if I were to do like say somehow in the future I did a new game run, another new game run, and like I actually got everything to go right. I did the good Garador and I got a good elevator, like a run like this, okay? And I got past chapter 4-4, I'd be like, oh, world record's like basically guaranteed. Like, I'm secure. That's how I'd feel about it. I'm like, oh, I just got the record. Like, it's... yeah, it's really strange. I don't know. I feel like I'm really consistent in chapter 5. I don't know if it was just because of all that practice I did for that one race. But yeah, we can do that Skype race too. That's no problem. Are we doing co-op? We do co-op. If you're doing single player, that's not going to be fair, because your partner's going to suck. Your AI is going to suck.
Let's see. Chapter 5-3. I wish Carpenter was here so I could ask him. I think it's Koro. Koro Corruptor has a strat in the It Cage. Where, to use the grenade, I stole that strat from him to do. If you guys know what I'm talking about. Also, I always reload that just because, like, when you jump down there, there's always guys in your face. And I don't want to get wombo comboed. And it's just, like, it's just as fast to reload as it is to stand up, pretty much. So, there you go. Is it White Finger? It's White Finger. Okay. I always get White Finger and Koro's stuff confused for some reason. That's funny. I knew it was someone playing on Japanese. But yeah, he has a grenade strat that I stole. And it's really nifty. And then obviously you're gonna get hyped for the Adi statue. Copyrighted Adi statue. Yeah, you can ask someone on speedrun.com. Because I think a lot of them have PS3. I think me and Snow and Outrage are pretty much the only ones with 360. I don't know. I think everyone else plays PC and PS3. You don't really need to switch and use the TMP here, but it's, like, safer for me to do. Like, you don't waste that much time using it. That way you can actually see if you're hitting the truck. That's just my opinion, but whatever. Also, I run around the left side of the table now. The right side's slower, I believe. Also, my inventory was, like, trash at that point. As you can see, the Magnum ammo was, like, in a weird spot. Now, like I told you with the whole merchant thing. Oh, yeah, I couldn't grab this money. I don't even think I needed it, but I was like, why can't I grab it? I was like, that's... like, would not give it to me. I was just like, dude, give me the money. What the heck? So, knife fight, I'm going to go ahead and skip, because, yeah, no point. Oh, come on. Okay. Yep. This part's pretty boring. Man, I don't know about you guys, but I'm ready to go work out. Ready for this run to be over so I can go work out.
What time is it?
It's almost 7:30, so won't be that late. I thought it was going to be like 8 whenever I had to go to the gym, but
it'll be like 7:45.
It's not too bad. Just ready to get up and get out and do something, move around. Been sitting down all day. Alright, so in the third cage, you'll get to see the grenade strut. I do it really slow, just because I had just learned it before this run, I think. Now I'm quicker at it. But it's really good. It's really nifty. I like using it a lot more than the old strat, where you just like throw it up against the door or whatever. I don't even know what you're talking about, Rich, so no. I have two grenades at this point because one I use in 5-4, but it's also good to have two just in case somehow you miss this throw, your run's just not completely over, you know?
So it's good to have that backup, and I also use it in 5-4, so it's a double whammy type thing. Like, it helps me in both situations. If I end up using both in this area, then I go and grab the one in the cabinet right before the merchant area of this chapter. Also, I didn't mean to grab that TMP ammo. I was only trying to grab the magnum ammo and the herb, but I was a little bit too close still to the TMP ammo, and it gave it to me, and I was just like, whatever, I'm about to sell it anyways. I finally timed this the other day. And if you were to do Dittman normally without going to that inventory like I just did to switch stuff around, Dittman saves you like literally maybe like a fourth of a second. But yeah, I would grab that grenade right there if I had missed and ended up using both. I would have just grabbed that one. See, at that point, that's when you would normally sell the crown, but I had already sold it. I didn't know where to put that. Like, you can see I'm still, like, really new at the game. Didn't know, like, where stuff needed to go. It's hilarious. What's up, Costa? Puerto Rican guy, what's up? So this part, I'll get ready for the Audi statue. Yay, Audi statue. Copyrighted. Restricted. I don't know that I've ever seen anyone else do it. I may be completely wrong and then I won't be able to call it my own. But I'm pretty sure. Like, I know Outrage always comments about how good my statue pushes. Like, I seem to always get the perfect amount of pixels to do it. And even if I don't, I make the statue do what I want. But the new thing is, there's a secret that for some reason no one knew. So good Krauser. Really good Krauser. Alright. So, here's the secret. You ready? You ready for this? The secret, while pushing the statue, is to hold up on the control stick. What this allows you to do is, you know how like Leon goes inside of the statue? Well, if you hold up, he'll go through it when you're done, and then you can just turn around and hit the statue really quick. Don't know why we never thought of this. Yes, yes. There you go. It's not how it's normally done. Normally, we let go, we go like all the way around it. I was behind it, and then you just turn around and grab it. Dude, I have so many herbs, holy crap. I have so many healing items, I was ready for 5-4. It's like, wow. I was so ready. Okay, this Krauser, I'm pretty sure was, like, bad. Let me see. Oh god, oh god. Dude, I got so lucky, like, three times. Oh god, again. Oh my gosh, like, I was not close enough. I was not close enough. At all. to him. Like, I was super far away, so, like, I was barely nicking him. That almost ruined me, like, four times. Holy crap. Well, then we'll call it the sleep statue. We'll say, like, you always are inside of it. But, like, normally what would happen is, like, everyone would just, like, you know, once we get enough pushes, we would let go, and we would, like, end up on the side of it. Rather than, like, in front of it. Like, here's the statue, right? Like, this is the statue. Okay? And, like, you're pushing it this way. So, like, we would be pushing, and you would end up on the side of it. But, like, this is pushing, then I end up on this side of it. If that makes sense. Like, I'm on the opposite side where you need to be. So, like, it saves, like, a half a second. Like, there's nothing to it. Like, it's just something stupid. Alright, this 5-4. For some reason, I always get shot here. No matter what I do, I always get shot. Like, that arrow guy is just on point every time. Every single time. Yeah, you see what I'm saying? Like, everyone always ends up being on the left side of it. I'm actually on the opposite side completely. So, like, I could just, like, turn around and, like, go straight to where I need to push the statue in. Rather than, like, going around. I just go, whoop. I ended up moving that, I don't know why I did that, actually. Oh, I know why I did that. Because I would need it in a second. But, like, normally I would have my running incendiary that I forgot to grab at the guard door at this point, and that's what I would use to continue doing Ditman to that. You know, I would use that to run, so. Ugh, work. Works. Not cool, dude. Offline. Mike took forever, it seemed like, anyways. Normally he shoots it a lot quicker, but he was there late or something, I don't know. It took forever. The rest of this is all normal. Oh yeah, the reason I still have that grenade is because I got the good Mike RNG. Normally I bank on Mike not even giving me anything. So, like, what will normally happen is I'll run back to where I'm about to go down the ladder, and I'll throw that grenade. I'll throw it and immediately jump down, and by the time I jump down, it's blown up, and everyone down there is dead. So that way, like, I can just not worry about getting wombo comboed. So, that's the reason I still have it, is because Mike did give me the good RNG, so I didn't need to use it. Guessing that should is showed, but if so, then thank you. I hope some of them get used at some point. Like, obviously, like I said, some of them, like, I've had to explain some things that, like, I didn't actually do in this one that I've done in, like, more recent runs, like a few days ago. But that's why I made this video, kind of, was just to tell you what the strats were, so that way, in case, like, you wanted to come back and see some of them, that way, you know, I wanted to hog all these strats to me and for me and Carpenter, just so, like, I could get the world record without anyone, like, having this knowledge to maybe take it away from me in case someone wanted to try it, you know. But now that I don't care. that's why I'm sharing it with everyone, so that, like, all the new game pro runners can have all these, you know, new strats, I guess, or whatever, so that they can maybe implement them and try them out and save time, because I want the community just to be faster and better. I don't, you know, obviously I was going to release them once I got my record, but, like, doesn't matter anymore. I'm always hesitant there. I always do the cutscene so that Ashley will be right next to me. Even on New Game Plus runs, like, I don't trust her because she'll crouch and cower over my own. I ain't having that crap. Not having that in my house. So the rest of this is normal, so there you go. That was my very sloppy and poor attempt at New Game. I'm going to say probably never again will New Game Pro be happening for me unless it's in a, you know, some kind of community race or RE4 Central race type thing where, like, you know, we want like a bunch of New Game runners to do, then I might, I'll get in that just for fun, because it's not, like, there's no pressure in that, that's all for fun. Other than that, I'm not going to do it anymore. So this is it. Yep. Had I got the world record at some point, too, I was going to do the Bye Felicia, just because... Because, like, I don't have any world records that showcase the Bye Felicia. All of them are just, like, standard, normal, where you just get on the boat, like, as fast as you can. But, like, I wanted one that showcased it off. I may have, like, one of the easy free world records, like the PC07 one or something that I did it on. But, like, none of the, like, real ones, you know? Like, the ones that actually have competition in them, so. Yeah. Just look at those splits, like, look how much time I lost in 4-4, it's so awesome. And then my time loss in 3-1 and 3-2, like, that's so, so cool. But yeah, that auto splitter works so good, pitted, works so good. So good. Steam. PC, 30 FPS. Yep. My summon best at that point was a 138.02. I got it to a 137.22. So, yeah. That was my old time. Look at that. 144.49, and then straight to 140. Like, okay. Wow. Alright, time to go work out. There you go. That was some strats. You now know. Have fun with them. Do what you will with them. I don't care. Don't care anymore. New Game Plus run? Yeah, okay. Haven't done New Game Plus in, I don't know how long. I'm getting away from RE4 for a long time. Except for races. And teaching people stuff, so I'm gonna just go do RE5 with snow and stuff. So, yep. See you later.